Okay, so in today's Daily Cyber, we're going to be working on cyber insurance. I'm going up into Woodbridge to a talk and an information session, be able to provide my knowledge and expertise. So I'm really excited that I don't know how much I'm going to be able to record because I think it's a very private, confidential event, but I want to talk about it before and then after I go. So let's hack at it. So as I mentioned, I'm going to an insurance information session, and the main topic is going to be cybersecurity and cyber insurance, looking at cyber policies and making sure that the insurance company is covered as well as the clients, business owners, that when they make a claim, they're covered as well. So we want to make sure that it's a 360-degree evaluation for cyber insurance to make sure everyone's covered. Because the important thing right now when you look at cyber attacks is that companies want to make sure they have the technology, the systems in place, you know, have their security solutions there, and that if they have to pay out in claims or in damages, whatever that may be, that they have insurance to help them support them, you know, when they make a claim. But what happens is the insurance company has to make sure that the company has their due diligence, that they've done their risk assessment, they've done a cybersecurity assessment as well, and they have everything in place so that if they ever do get attacked, their system's going to be in place, like antivirus, firewall, unified threat management tools. These things are going to be in place to help to prevent any massive damages, any issues with data loss, anything along that line. So that's what I'm up to, going to right now into Concord. And like I said, I don't know if I mentioned, but I don't know if I can record the actual session itself just because it's a private session. And what's going to happen is it's going to be a lot of confidential information. So I'm going to be talking about, you know, certain topics, certain things after that I can discuss. And I really have some questions for you. Like, first and foremost, when's the last time you had a cybersecurity assessment done? Have you had a risk assessment done on your business? And do you have cyber insurance? And, you know, what does it cover? Have you really kind of talked through your broker and just said, look, you know, what does it cover? What happens when I make a claim? Like all this, you know, great information. We need to start having this discussion because as we see in the news, cyber attacks are so prevalent that it's not if you're going to get attacked, it's when you're going to get attacked and then how are you going to deal with it? So I'm going to leave off there. Like I said, I'm just on my way to Concord right now to go to the insurance broker's office to go listen to this presentation and, you know, provide some insight from myself being, you know, the account manager from Go Secure. Okay, so I'm just finished the cyber insurance seminar that I went to go and sit in and learn. It was really interesting. It was at Brokers Trust Insurance. My colleague and business partner, Joseph Carvalho, was the one that invited me out. And thank you so much, Joseph. It was an amazing event. I learned so much. And it was interesting to be able to listen from the insurer travelers on their cyber policy, what they do to protect, what they do to assess. And Joseph and I are going to be working extremely, extremely close together to make sure that our clients, the people that we work, have a 360-degree holistic cybersecurity solution, being that they do a proper baseline. They make sure, like, they do a security assessment, cybersecurity assessment. They do a risk analysis or a risk assessment, sorry. They do all this due diligence right up front. And the reason for that is that they know what they have, what they need to fix, what it will cost. And then as they go through remediation potentially for their business impact analysis, what it's going to cost, they look at transference and look at insurance. And we want to make sure when they go and get cyber insurance that they have coverage, right? And then just that they have coverage for their business and their technology and potential incident, but the claim will be accepted and that they'll be covered. And that's a very key point here, is because when we're talking to the travelers and we're talking about people that answer the questionnaires, you know, patch management, having appliances that are up to date, like all these security solutions and systems sometimes are not where it needs to be. And then what happens when companies make a claim because they've been breached and all of a sudden the claim's denied because, yeah, they don't meet that certain criteria. Or our goal is to make sure the clients that we work with need that baseline, at least minimum, right, to make sure that all their claims are covered. So that's why Joseph and I really care about this, is because it's not just, you know, about making money or anything along that line. That's besides the point. We really care about business, and we really care about the people we work with, and we want to make sure they're protected as they grow, right? And this is our solution to be able to do this. So I'm really excited about that. So if you have any questions, comment below. And oh, wanted to add this. So in Ontario, I think it's actually in Canada, November 1st, 2018, there's new legislation coming out that if a company gets compromised, they're going to have to report it. Right? Legally, they're going to have to report it. Well, you look at that, when it gets assessed after you're reporting it, they look at negligence and look at, you know, who's responsible. And if the company's not doing their due diligence, they could be held negligent about the data breach and what will happen and the compromise. And maybe there was data, like personal identifiable information data that was released. Now the company can be, you know, financially and potentially criminally responsible. So this is why we need to make sure that companies of all sizes protect themselves. So that's it for today's video. I want to finish off there. Don't forget, you know, one thing, comment below if you have any questions. But these videos are going to keep going. I'm really excited about them. Lots of information to cover. So don't forget, software is hackable. Being connected is vulnerable. I'll see you next video.